Welcome to World Communications Day. On the 57th World Day of Communications, Pope Francis focuses on the theme, Speaking with the Heart, the Truth in Love. He wants to focus on speaking with the heart. It is the heart that spurs us to go, to see and to listen. And it is the heart that moves us towards an open and welcoming way of communicating. Once we have practiced listening, which demands waiting and patience, as well as foregoing the assertion of our own point of view in a prejudicial way, we can enter into the dynamic dialogue and sharing, which is precisely that of communicating in a cordial way. After listening to the other with a pure heart, we will also be able to speak following the truth in love. A heart that reveals the truth should be listened to. This leads those who listen to attune themselves to the same wavelength, to the point of being able to hear within their heart also the heartbeat of the other. Then the miracle of encounter can take place, which makes us look at one another with compassion, welcoming our mutual frailties with respect rather than judging by hearsay and sowing discord and division. Communicating in a cordial manner means that those who read or listen to us are led to welcome our participation in the joys, fears, hopes, and suffering of the people of our time. Those who speak in this way love the other because they care and protect their freedom without violating it. We can see this in the style of the mysterious wayfarer, the risen Jesus, who dialogues with the disciples headed to Emmaus after the tragedy that took place on Calvary. The risen Jesus speaks to them with the heart, accompanying the journey of their suffering with respect, proposing himself and not imposing himself, lovingly opening their minds to understand the profound meaning of what had happened. Indeed, they can joyfully then exclaim that their hearts burned within them as he spoke to them on the road and explained the scriptures to them. One of the convictions of St. John Henry Newman was, in order to speak well, it is enough to love well. It shows that for him, communication could never be reduced to something artificial, to a marketing strategy, as we might say nowadays. But it is rather a reflection of the soul, the visible surface of a nucleus of love that is invisible to the eye. For St. Francis de Sales, precisely in the heart and through the heart, there comes about a subtle, intense, and unifying process in which we come to know God. It is from this criterion of love that we are reminded that we are what we communicate. This goes against the grain of today at a time when we experience, especially on social media, communication is often exploited so that the world may see us as we would like to be seen and not what we really are, through our posts on Instagram or our selfies on Messenger. During this synodal journey in the church, Pope Francis makes us recall, in the church too, there is a great need to listen to and to hear one another. It is the most precious and life-giving gift we can give to each other. Listening without prejudice, attentively and openly. It gives rise to speaking according to God's style, nurtured by closeness and compassion and tenderness. So, on this 57th World Communications Day, let us resolve to do this. I wish you a wonderful communicative spirit.